Hi folks, just a little update vlog this one on a bit of an overcast Sunday morning. About 9:30 in the morning. We're just going to pop down to the cafe to have some breakfast. See you in a minute. Right, well, I've got a little bit of news to tell you about the Reliant Regal chassis. As you know, it's been away for about 3 weeks now to be sandblasted. And I've been trying to contact the bloke. I couldn't get hold of him. I've been phoning him up, leaving messages and stuff, and he's not got back to me. I've been down there twice to see him. He's not been there. So I went down yesterday and he was there and spoke to him. We had a little word of him sort of thing and said, "You're a hard bloke to get on with," in so many words. And he said, "Oh, what number you've been trying to call?" I've had the wrong number. I've been phoning the wrong number and leaving messages at the wrong place. So that's the reason why. Anyway, cut a long story short, he did start it and he stopped. And the reason why he stopped is the chassis has got loads of holes in it. So it's full of holes, the Reliant chassis. So he couldn't go ahead and finish it off and powder coat it. He had to wait till he saw me. So what I'm going to do is, I said to him, "Well, you just sandblast it totally. I'll take it away and then I'll weld up what's got to be done and then I'll ship it back to you and then we get it powder coated." So that's been the hold up with the Reliant chassis anyway. So I've been obviously going and doing bits on the Triumph, as you know. That again has been slow progress. I keep meaning to get out there and finish that off. I wanted it running this weekend. That's not going to happen now anyway. But we've had a lot to do with looking after the family. Little one's been in hospital, one of the grandchildren's been in hospital, and we've had the other two kids. So that's what's been happening there. But we've been doing a little bit in the garden. I did started to clear the weeds in the garden because they have grown up quite a lot. Here, look at Bison. Look. Oi, get off of there. Away. Go on, off. Away. As you can see, the weeds in the pond around the pond are quite established. And I started pulling them up. But we also, as I said to you before, people have mentioned that the pond's not looking great at the moment, as you know. But we're going to be draining this lot out, so it's a slow process. The grass has grown again. That's been cut twice last week due to the rain. And on our little gooseberry plant, I don't know whether you can see or not, we've actually got little gooseberries. There's actually stacks of them on these plants. You haven't seen in the polytunnel for a good while. Now again, I've not done anything in here. Sharon's been doing this. And I come in here yesterday and I thought, oh, she ain't done too bad. As you can see, things are sprouting and things have been growing nicely. So she's done well. We've got beetroot there, she's got spinach there, more spinach there. There's our onions growing along the back there, as you can see. The lettuces have come in on well at the front there. Radish at the end there. That's a cucumber plant, which is nearly died off, I think, and she had to do something about it. She found slugs all over it. Over here, we've got more cucumbers. We've been eating the radish already in our salads. There's some watercress over there. That's strawberries, and these are obviously tomato plants. At the back there, there's a cow plant. So yeah, we've got some more tomato plants, which again, these are what we've grown from seed and they've grown up really nice. She's also got some more lettuce there to go out. So all in all, she's actually not done too bad. She's never really done this, first time she's done it. So I mean, I've only done it sort of first time. We're into our third year now. So I've done it for the past two seasons, so to speak. And obviously this is her first time and I think she's done pretty well. Sorry, what's that, baby? Eh? I'm not shocked, baby. I'm praising you. I said you've done very well.
I've grown tomato plants.
Yeah, well, everyone done when they was a kid.
I still did when we was here. Cheek.
Baby, I'm on your side. Look at your empire. Gonna submerge yourself in your little empire. I'm praising her, and she's having a go at me. What's that all about? Baby.
It's on the finish, isn't it?
I was on your side, baby. Look, I was on your side. Just saying all this you've done yourself.
Yeah.
And you've never done all this before. I haven't told you.
Well, you ain't going to do it, was you?
Lady, I've kept you fed for the last 2 years out of our polytunnel, baby.
Well, I've been starving this year if I didn't come in.
Oh, you're funny. And I'm taking you out for a nice cooked breakfast on a Sunday morning.
Trying to lose weight.
It doesn't get any better than that. We'll do that next week, baby.
What, lose weight?
Yeah, we're going to the gym regularly now, as I say.
I go jazzercise.
She goes jazzercise. I'm down the gym now 3 times a week with Jimmy. So we're doing all right there. But we've got to sort out our eating and do what they call clean eating. See, because we've got quite a leisurely lifestyle, we eat out a lot, and all that food is no good for you. It's processed and all that. So
oh my god, God.
Hold on.
And it's on my lettuce.
What's that, Sharon? Look at him. Look at him out, Sharon.
He's dead now, I think.
Yeah, see?
I don't like killing things.
No, we don't like killing them. But on the raised bed the other week, as I told you, we got over 100 out, Sharon, didn't we?
Snails.
That's better. I like the way you shout. I like it. Coming out, Duchess. So we're just waiting.
Did you show the gooseberries?
Yeah, I've just shown him the gooseberries. So we're just waiting for Gary to turn up now, because apparently Gary, Stacey and the kids are going to be coming round this afternoon, and we're going to be... What are they doing? Oh, they're having dinner here, aren't they? Yeah. Because we're going to try... I'm going to try and do some work on the Triumph.
Jimmy's doing Gary's car.
Jimmy's doing some work on Gary's car?
The bumper.
Oh, yeah. We might have a look at that a bit later on.
I don't know. Hang on. I might have got that wrong.
We've got...
I think he's got to get some paint.
Right, we've got Jimmy's handbrake, which we've got to do. That might not happen today. I've got to cut the grass. That's got to be done, definitely, because that's now really too long. Mm. I was going to strip down the Triumph carburetors today and clean them out before I put them back on. So that's one thing I was going to do today. Gary's coming around, as I say.
Marty!
What else was there? Got to cut the grass. In between the cracks on the patio, I bought some ready-mixed cement, which I was just going to try and drop in the cracks to try and stop these weeds.
It's all grown through again.
I know, it does, Sharon. It will do. So that's what I've got there.
How long it takes to do anything?
Yesterday we had quite a fun and games. We had Tracey, as you don't know if you know, Tracey's got her own hairdressing salon now, down in our local village. And she called it a name. And I've always done, as you know, with the other business we've got the old t-shirt transfers, we've got stuff like that. But I had some old vinyl for windows, which I've never really done before, to be honest with you. I've done a couple of little ones, but definitely not on a big scale of a big 6-foot sign. So I said, oh, no worries, I'll do that for you. So I took the old sign down. It was grey in colour, and someone had painted it. So I sanded it all down, painted it white, and then I thought I'll cut the vinyl out on the vinyl cutter. And she didn't know what we was doing, me and Sharon. I'm bringing you into this, baby.
Yeah, don't bring me into
it. I'm bringing her because...
I wasn't there.
Because I got her to proofread it. Anyway, cut a long story short.
Not.
Listen, baby, I'm telling them first.
You're telling fibs.
We made the sign up. Went down the shop, shout, Tracey.
Hang on, dog's gone under the patio.
Tracey was in the shop, working, and we did. Is he? Is it? Barney's gone under the decking. Gosh, yeah, tell him off.
Get.
Tell him off.
Come here.
Oh, just trod on the snail. Anyway, so yeah, we took the sign out of the car and got the ladders out, put it up, and Sharon said, "It's the wrong name. I'd done the hair studio." It weren't called the hair studio, it was called, what was it, Sharon?
Hair lounge.
The hair lounge. Didn't realise. Now, we both made the sign up, we both looked at it, we both put it up. Hold on, Sharon. Oh, I don't know, that might be a deadly one.
Yeah, it's come out.
Sort that out in a minute. Anyway, didn't say no to Tracey, went in and said, right, we think there's a little problem with it. We took her out. I said, right, turn around, and when you look at it, tell me if you can see what the little problem is. She looked around, she looked at it, she said, well, I can't see. It looks all right. I said, it shouldn't say the hair studio, it should be the hair lounge, shouldn't it? Oh, that was it, wasn't it? So, of course, it's got to come down again. So then we took it down, and I didn't have enough vinyl. Oh, cut a long story short, we had to pull it all off and redo it again. But it's up now. We went back last night and put it up, Sharon, didn't we?
Yeah.
And it looks all right. What was that mushroom, Sharon?
Look,
we've just seen this. It's in our raised bed. We don't know what it is. Let me show you. You might know what it is. Is it poisonous? Let us know. Where is it, Sharon?
There.
Just give it a little flick. Is that dirt on it? Is that a mushroom? Are you sure?
You come out here and see all the grooves on it, like the mushroom, the lines.
Oh, is it? Oh, right. But anyone know what that is? Let us know, because it's in our raised bed. And obviously we're not going to eat it, but we want to know if you can tell. Can I have a look underneath it, Sharon? Lift it towards you.
It's probably poisonous.
No, you won't.
I'm touching poisonous
here. Yeah. Oh, she broke it anyway. Yeah, look, that's what it is underneath. It's white underneath, look. I don't know whether that's poisonous or what. Let us know, anyone, if you know anything about mushrooms. Right, well, anyway, so that's what's happened there. So if we drive past the shop, I'll show you the sign which me and Sharon done. We've never done big signs like that before. We had a little go. We think it's all right, but we'll show you that in a minute. We're going to go inside now, wait for Gary, and we'll see you in a minute. Bye for now. Right, well, here we are in the VXR, and Mummy's in the back. Say hello, Mummy.
Hello, keep quiet.
What?
Keep quiet.
Keeping quiet, that's right. So, yeah, in Woodall Spa this weekend, there's a beer festival on. First one, it just happened over the weekend. Jimmy was there yesterday and he got a bit jolly, but me and Mummy didn't go because we don't drink anymore. Well, Mummy didn't drink anyway, but Daddy don't drink anymore. So here's our little sign, what we've done. Let's just pull up to it here, hold on.
Oh, it's fallen down.
As you can see, there's our little attempt there, our first attempt at a sign. Me and Sharon. And yesterday it said the hair studio. But yeah, there we go. So that's not too bad anyway. So she's happy with it, Tracey, anyway. Plus it gives her own unique identity to her shop. Right, we're going down to the cafe now and we'll see you a little bit later. Bye for now. There they go. This is a little shop we go to on the way to Skegness. Gary's just going in there now with Mummy, Sharon. And we don't know whether we're going to have a barbecue yet. I'm not too sure. Or whether she gets some meat. Anyway, we'll leave you here and I'll let them go and do their stuff and I'll see you when we get back home. See you in a minute. Here, look, we've just come out into the garden and there's a bird stuck in our raised bed. Let's have a look, I'll show you. Give us a hand, girl. Get out there, you. Barney's trying to get in there. Barney, out. Get him out. Hold on, beautiful fella. Come on, this way. Come on. Out you come. Yeah, look, come on out. Where are you, little fella? Come on out, come on. Come on. Oh, he's just shot out, look. How many got out of that little gap over there, look. I'll have to peg that up properly. Oh, he's obviously getting in there. We've had a bird stuck in there before. They're probably after the snails. Look, see the snails down there, look. That's what we've been having in the raised bed. And over here, look, they're everywhere, look. And the shells are empty, but we had to put the pellets around the top, these slug pellets, just to stop all the snails going up. Right, what you got to look for here then? Right, you've got a lawnmower to repair, haven't you? These are all mine up here. Yeah? Hello? Oh yes, turn that light on. That one had a bent crank if I remember rightly. Yeah. That vibrated, didn't it?
Yeah.
So here's the carbs. This is what I hopefully will be working on a bit later on. As you can see, they're a bit skanky, but when you look inside, I don't know if you can actually see in there, there's a bit of corrosion down the bottom of the choke flap there, so I thought to myself, I might as well take the bottoms off at least. You know, you can unbolt these four bolts there, take the float bowls off and have a look inside as well, and probably blow them all out and get some carb clean on them. Give all this a bit of a wash down as well, all the linkages and stuff like that. I'm not going to go too far with that. Maybe paint this bracket and just give these a bit of a clean up. I'm not sure yet, but we'll play that by ear. So yeah, that's the log cabin and the carburetors, which I hope to get to a little bit later. Gary's got a few lawnmowers down the side. They come out of the way, Bison. An old Briggs & Stratton one he's after. He's got, what, the pool called solid? Is it? Yeah, that one could be seized up, couldn't it? No engine on that one. There's one that turns over. That might be alright, mightn't it? So you know you've got an engine anyway. This is that old Shrin Stingray bike I was telling you about in one of my previous vlogs. The Shade Tree Fix-It Man, George from America, he had one of these and he actually put a lawnmower engine in it and converted it, and it went quite well actually. I think he sold it now, he might have sold it by now, but just to show you, I've got that and I've got plenty of lawnmower engines, so I might even come up with a project. This was Jimmy's when he was about 8 years old. But unfortunately, as you can see there, it's been sitting outside in all sorts of weather and it's totally gone really, so that'll all be sandblasted. Though they're still solid, although it's only surface rust on there. But the chassis is all right, as you can probably see there. Come on, you dogs. We've always got plenty to do here. And things mount up, but you've got to get into the habit of getting things done and moving forward. So let's put that back there and let's go and see what Gary's doing. Right, you've got about 40, 45 minutes before a bloke comes up, and you need this engine, don't you, off this lawnmower here?
Yeah.
So obviously he's not going to do nothing with a deck. The deck's corroded and rotten. So he's got to get this engine off. This is a self-drive one. Yeah. Does that matter? Right, let's see what we can do with this.
I've got so much to do, man.
Oh. can't beat that, can you?
Hold on, come on.
All right, there we go. That is now ready to go into a lawnmower. There's still a good few parts left on that though, aren't there?
Yeah, the wheels and the flap.
Wheels and the flap and the handle and stuff. So that, yeah, the deck's totally rotten, as you can see. Look, it's flexing there, look. So that will get stripped down. Bits kept for that for spares, and the rest will be thrown away. Yeah, that's overfilled, isn't it?
Looks like it, though.
Now it's overfilled, isn't it?
Looks like it.
God, that's black, isn't it? Look at it. That's well overfilled, isn't it?
Yeah.
As you can probably see there, that one has been well overfilled. And this is one we haven't looked at yet, so you can guarantee that this will probably be all right. Although it's going to need a good clean off. Well, all we're basically doing here is stripping the top of the engine down just to make sure that everything's okay. As you can probably see there, we do need some new springs there. Someone's had to play about with the springs. This lawnmower, as you can probably see, was drastically overfilled, which is probably why it might have been smoking, running or whatever. Someone's had a go at tinkering about, as you can see, with the spring mechanisms. So, you know, these are things that you can assess just by looking at it to see what the possible problems are. Again, this has been standing outside for well, maybe 2 years. So, you know, it's the internal should be okay, but most of the problems are due to basic servicing and user error, in other words, for overfilling the oil. So we can assess that from what we've just found by just by sort of the basic strip down which we're doing here. But we'll give it a general clean off and blowing it all down with the air hose, and you'll probably see, well, look at this, look inside there, look. That's where you can see where it's been sitting about for years and years, probably, before we even had it. So we'll just give this a quick douse down now with a bit of a solution of a cleaning solution and a brush. Blow it off with the air hose, and then you'll see it will greatly look a lot better. So that's what we're going to do now. Right, well, there we go. As you can see there, that's just had a little bit of a cleaning with some cleaning solution, old style petrol, paraffin, whatever you may call it, bit of a paintbrush just to just to agitate it all, bit of an airline, and as you can see, that's a whole lot better than what it was. So Gary's got to take this engine away now because he's got a lawnmower around his house, and we're going to just fill it up with oil. I would imagine that the diaphragm and gasket's going to possibly be okay in this one because it was overfilled. And Gary's got a spare diaphragm and gasket anyway to be out of services when he puts it on the lawnmower, which he's got to repair. And yeah, just something to tinker about with. That's all it is, playing about. We've got a few of these lawnmowers floating about, and it's that simple to work on these little Briggs and Stratton engine ones. Forget about anything more complicated if you've not done this before. Stick with a simple Briggs and Stratton basic engines with the old push prime carburetors on them, with the detachable fuel tanks on the side like this one, and you'll have so much more fun learning how they work and learning how to repair them, because they're quite simple to work on and repair, as you can probably see. So, hello baby, baby's coming here.
Okay,
hold on, come here baby. We just cleaned that lawnmower engine up, me and Gary.
Well done.
And he's taking it home now, isn't he? So what's happening now? What's actually happening with you, baby?
I'm going down the road to get some stuff for the barbecue.
We're having a barbecue. The sun's actually coming out now and it's getting quite nice out here now.
Tell my hands out, they're freezing.
Yeah, she gets cold very often, I don't know why.
Perhaps I'm ill.
You're not ill, baby. You're lovesick. Give husband a kiss, baby. Right, so she's going down the road. I'm going to cut the grass, I think, while you're doing
hey!
It. So I'm going to cut the grass because I didn't expect, no, we've used them all. So you'll have to get a bag of coals as well for the barbie. I didn't expect to be doing this at the moment. But
no,
as I said,
gone.
We never know what's going on here, baby, do we?
No, we never get to do what we want to do, actually.
Well, we are, because I enjoy doing what I'm doing.
Well, I've got loads to do and I'm still
What are you standing here talking to me for then, baby?
Because I've got to go and get all the rolls and everything.
Oh, hard work, isn't it, being a woman?
Charcoal. Yes, it is.
Baby.
Put the washing on, because no one else is going to put the washing on, are they? And do Listen. The ironing. And little things like that, which men forget women do.
Little things like, what did you say to me the other day? Oh, the dishwasher. No, not the dishwasher. The washing machine isn't working. Oh, suddenly that becomes my job. I've got to take it out. I've got to take the pump out. I've got to unblock the waste.
Yeah.
That is my job. Do you see me complaining, baby?
Yes, you did, actually.
I did, because I didn't want to do it, did I?
That's right, yeah. You even went online to look for a new one.
Yeah, but I didn't say you...
And there was nothing wrong with
but
the
I
machine.
But I didn't criticise you, baby, saying that you can't do it, did I? I just got on with it. I tirelessly got on with the task that I'm meant to do in this relationship, which we got.
Relationship?
Yes.
Marriage?
Yes, it's a relationship of love, baby.
Marriage?
Yes. A unity of minds meeting... With different tasks to do.
God, this is go.
It's not.
Bless you.
Shut up, baby. Right, go on in, off you go. I've got to talk sensible to these people. Who's Gary's talking to? Gary's. I think Gary's talking to the bloke whose lawnmower he's repairing.
That's Stacey, because Sophie ain't saying lovely to the bloke who's above his car. I thought he was there.
Yeah, he's gone to get his stuff out of mine.
What's he getting?
All
right, so you're taking that now, yeah? You've got to fill it up with oil.
Yeah.
I haven't done that. I'll let you do something.
All right.
Yeah?
I thought I'd come back and it'll be done.
He said he thought it'd come back and it'll be done. I've done 99.9% of it. What part of it are you going to do?
I've got to rebuild the mower now.
He's got to rebuild the mower. He's got to take the engine out of one mower and put it in the other, like what we've just done here. Yeah? Three bolts. That's the great thing about these mowers. Three bolts, out it comes. So he's just going to fill. That's what I said to you before about having a table, a worktop, with a hole in it, because you can get the mower shaft through the hole in the table there, as I said to you before. Look, that hole in the table there. And it sits flat then, and it's easy to spin around and work on. I said that to you before. Those of you who work on lawnmowers, get yourself a hole in the table, make life a whole lot easier. You won't believe the amount of mowers that we get like this, which we get in, or people. You've had a couple, Gary, where someone said to you, you had one last week where someone said that the mower is not running properly, it's smoking, blah blah blah, and it was literally filled up to the top, wasn't it?
Yep.
So people literally don't realise how much oil goes in these mowers. And it was a new mower. Yeah, this woman had this mower about 12 months, and because she'd not used it like for a season, she thought that, oh well, it must need oil. So she just kept topping up and up until she could actually see the oil in the top of the thing, and wonder why it was really hard to pull over. She's actually lucky she didn't get what they call hydraulic lock, and that would have gone solid, sort of thing, you know. We don't use any special oil in these. We use basic car oil. We get this cheap. This is just a 10W40. It really wants to be a bit thinner than this, I think, but it does the job. See, we normally know that when he fills it up, three cups of this little funnel we got gets us near enough in the ballpark. Yeah, so it's just touched it. So he had two cupfuls in that cup, so he normally fills up with three. And that normally gets us nearly where we want to be. So Yeah, that's what we do there. So looking at this one, he's got possibly a set of springs on that, but as you say, the old mower, which he's got,
should have them on.
He should have them on. You've got the boss on the other mower, so that should hopefully just go straight onto there. So that shouldn't be a problem. You've got a carbon diaphragm kit, just in case you need to do that.
Yeah.
So right, we just wound this in again. Always wind it fully in, and then take it straight out, and let's have a look and see what this is on the dipstick. There we go, just perfectly, under just under the fall line there. So for us, that's how we know three of these full gets us to where we need to be. So on this job, I'm purely here as a advisory capacity, and I end up doing bloody some of the work for him.
Job done.
So he's just going to take this away now, go home, meet the bloke at his house, and I don't know if you want to take your spark plug with you, Gary.
Yeah.
In the drawer, we always keep a stock of spark plugs. I restocked the spark plugs, by the way.
Yeah.
You got one?
Yeah.
Where is it?
Just
whack that on. Whack that in?
You took it off.
Unbelievable. When you work on the same lawnmowers for, like, on a regular basis, or look out or search for the same lawnmowers, as I say, we keep a stock of spark plugs, we keep a stock of the gaskets and diaphragms, we keep a stock of other things. I think I might even have a few springs about, and also the air filters as well, things like that. Ideal. Plus all the second hand parts we've got of exhaust and coil leads and stuff like that. So it's always handy to, if you want to build up some sort of stock and have spares. I mean, Gary wouldn't have been able to take this as a replacement if we didn't have these spare old lawnmowers laying about, even if they got rusty decks. This is going to solve his problem. He's going to bug off home now and come back a little bit later, and I'm going to carry on and do a bit of work in the garden. So we'll see you a bit later. Bye for now. Say ta-da.
Ta-da.
Get rid of it. Go, go, go. Right, well, I'm just going to poodle along in the garden. What? Just hold on for a minute, will you? Wait there. Come here. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come on. No, you don't. I'm not a crap.
Oh, I have one. It's fantastic.
Right. I don't think you need to see all me playing about in the garden now. Sharon wants to go down the road. I'm going to tag along with her for just go a little bit of shopping with her.
But you have the garden to
cut. I'm going
to
do that. I was just telling them now. I'm going to cut the grass when I come back. I'm going to poodle along, doing a little bit of...
I'm going to poo along.
Doing a little bit of the... What's it called, that?
Can I just ask?
Shout. Hold on. Doing that. What's that? The gaps. What are they called?
Cementing.
Doing a cementing. That's it.
Is that what's cementing?
Yeah, well, that's it.
What are these here for?
They're for repair, baby. Look. Hey, say that again.
Look, repair, yeah?
Yes, baby.
Yeah. That's a mouse's house. That's a fairy's garden.
Sharon, what you don't realise is that engine I've just worked on with Gary, that was in the same condition. We don't repair...
Take the engines out and start cleaning.
Well, that's what we do, yes, baby.
Look, it's just piled up. It's a mess.
That kitchen is a mess. Go and get it sorted out.
I will do. But I do, you don't.
I do your stuff, I do loads of stuff. Anyway.
Oh, he does my stuff, here we go.
Here we go.
Look at the halo.
Who does the cooking on the cooking channel, baby?
Me.
Us. We're a team.
That's the only time I hold on.
We're a team, so this is as well as your mess, as well as my mess.
Oh, let's go to the
Sharon, look, I've got to go. I'm dying to go to the toilet. I've dying to go to the toilet, Sharon.
Boo-boo.
You're hanging this video out. I would have finished
boo-boo.
It by now.
And being a boo-boo, as Emily would say.
I'll see you later. We'll see boo-boo. You again in the next video when we've got more information on the Triumph Acclaim and also the Reliant Regal with the chassis problem we have with the
it will be no further on.
Shut up, Sharon. Right, we'll see you later. Say bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. See you later. Bye for now. I've got to go to the toilet, Sharon.